Welcome back to another tutorial from PowerDirector Made Simple. Today's video is all about the effects, filters, and LUTs available to PowerDirector users. I want to take a quick review of these features just to show you what is available for you. I have several videos on my timeline that were all obtained from iStock by Getty Images. I'll select the first clip that shows some yummy looking spare ribs on a silver plate with a few other vegetables. I'll then click on Effects at the top to reveal the three main categories: Video Effects, Filters and LUTs, and Third Party. I'll start with the Video Effects category on the left side, and then click on the Retro subcategory. There at the very top are two monochrome filters, each being slightly different from one another. I'll first click on Black and White, and you can see that the image in the preview window instantly changes to black and white. But what if I want the image to accentuate only the ribs and the red tomatoes and turn everything else into monochrome? Well, the answer is to use the next effect entitled Filter Color, which I'll drag down and drop onto the clip. For the time being, it doesn't really show what I want, but I'll open up the Effects Settings window by clicking on the small eye on the clip. With the settings window open, the secret is to click on the Focus Color button and click on the original image where it shows a reddish brown color of the ribs. The red tomatoes seem to always be in the same color range, so it might take a few attempts to get the right color from the ribs. I may have to move the color range around slightly to get the proper effect. But you get the idea of how you can focus the viewer's attention to only a single color range in the video while everything else is turned into black and white. I'll click on the small trash can icon in the settings window to remove that effect and close the setting window. There is another interesting effect called Old Movie, which seems to change the colors to an old brown tone with scratches, dust, and other marks in the video, where you can watch it in the preview window. I'll also preview the sepia effect, but I'm not very happy with this one. There are better sepia filters in PowerDirector, one of which you'll see later in this video. A little further down is the vignette effect, which can sometimes be useful in your videos. I'm going to move the playhead until it is over the second clip, which shows nine eyes. I'll drop that effect onto that video clip and then click on the small eye to open up the settings window. I'll first change the width down to about 25 or so it covers only the one eye in the center. I'll then change the alpha degree, which is similar to opacity, down to about 200 so that the other eyes can still be seen. I could leave the focus right in the middle, but maybe I want to draw attention to the one eye on the left. I'm going to click on the position button and modify it by moving the red center point until it is over the eye on the left. Then I'll click OK. Now, with the playhead near the beginning of this clip, I'm going to hit play. Yeah, it's a weird clip, isn't it? Well, this is PowerDirector made weird. I'll close out the settings window. There are many other effects for you to look at on your own. Just have the playhead over any timeline image, and then just click on any effect, testing them out one at a time. In the Haze subcategory is another useful one called Flip Canvas, which I'll merely select and then move the playhead over to the next clip of the American flag on a green screen. I'll then hit play to watch it in the preview window. Now, this is certainly one effect that you might find useful in your own videos. The next subcategory along the left is Particles, which contains a multitude of useful effects, For example, I'll place the bubble effect onto the video clip of the traffic interchange. And then I'll click on the eye to modify the settings. I'll set the smallest size to about 100, the largest to about 200, and the density to about 150, and the 3D depth I'll move all the way to the max. Then I'll move the playhead to the beginning of the clip and hit play. Well, that's kind of neat, huh? But when would you ever want to use this or some other special effects in any of your real videos? Well, the answer is seldom or perhaps never. Maybe only on special occasions or perhaps in titles is when you could use it. Well, for now, I'm just going to close out the settings window. Now, you can click on any or all of the other effects in Particles to check out what any of them look like. Some of the more interesting ones are candy canes, fireworks, force lightning, GPU star, rain, snow, and water ripple. Now next is the distortion subcategory. Make sure to check these out, such as double fisheye, drain, fisheye, horizontal stretch, kaleidoscope, laser, mirror, ripple, square, squeeze, triangle stretch, vertical stretch, water reflection, which is a favorite of mine, and finally wave. I'll let you step through all of the filters in the texture category on your own. Now next, I'll click on the filters and LUTs category to open up a multitude of various subcategories here. For those that are not familiar with LUTs, that stands for lookup table, which is a means to take the color input of a source clip and modify it according to a set of predetermined parameters that are specified for each LUT. I'll click on the retro film category, all of which will make your video look as if it were processed on old 16mm or 35mm film stock. I'll skip down to the portrait subcategory, which displays various LUTs which you can apply to your clips. And until you get more familiar with the various LUTs, you can spend a lot of time clicking on each one, trying to make a decision as to which one creates the look that you are attempting to get. I'm going to go on down to the next subcategory called Vintage. And then I'm going to scroll down until I find the Vintage Sepia filter near the end. I'm going to move the playhead all the way back to the first clip of the ribs, and then click on the Vintage Sepia filter. Watch how it looks in the preview window. Now, this is a much better looking sepia image than what I saw using the sepia effect in the effects category and retro subcategory. Yes, folks, it's true. Some effects and filters are better than others. You're on your own for making the right choice. In the food subcategory, I'll quickly click through some of the LUTs and watch the preview window with the ribs. Moving on down to the colors subcategory, there's an interesting LUT down near the bottom called brown highlights. Notice that it has nearly the same effect on the spare ribs as the previously applied effect called filter color. And I'm intentionally skipping over the final category called third party, which contains Boris FX subcategories, because these are some of the best and most special of all. I want each of you to just drop any video on the timeline and then step through the various effects available with Boris FX. If you apply any one to a clip, make sure to click on the small eye to open up the settings window, especially the Boris vignette effect in the film style subcategory. And finally, as I move the click on the My Favorites category at the very top, you can see that I have several already marked as a favorite. These are ones that I have used on several occasions in the past, and I like that I can mark them as a favorite. Otherwise, I get very frustrated trying to find them again with the vast number of subcategories to search through. Now, maybe that's a good thing to have to do. Well, that's what CyberLink gives you to work with, which is all included with the program. Many of these same effects you can manually duplicate yourself by clicking on the video, then click on Edit, then Video, and then Color. But it would take you several hours of trial and error until you could even come up with something that is similar, and no matter how hard you try, it'll never be as good as what a specific LUT can do for your image. And besides, when you use the manual edit method, you can't save your specific steps of how you did it if you wanted to use it again on another clip. That's another advantage of using effects and LUTs. The wheel has already been invented just for you. So once again, and as always, I thank you for watching. I hope this video has been of some help to you. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. Click that like button and be sure to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already done so. I'll see you on the next one.